Andy, for sharing your perspective. Next is Yok Chen, affiliate.
China for 6 years. I would like to share with you my observation, but not to be scared by the hot and spicy topic. I will talk on the subject of feng shui perspective. There are more VC companies, more VC professionals, and more VC money into the China market. Okay, I think in the past 2 years, the most significant event is that the China market becomes the world's country. People from Shenzhen, from Japan, from Taiwan, from Israel, and from Japan, from Korea, all rush in to China market. And also at the same time, the phenomenon brought in a lot of new time, new funds, and new managers. And the last point, I think it's very important for the people rushing into China, not necessarily looking for direct investment into the Chinese steel. But at the same time, it's also very important for the foreign players to have the China presence to support their foreign portfolios. I summarize into five options or five models for the people joining the China market. There are companies setting up their China fund, going to the joint fund or kind of the franchising. And the model C is quite a lot of people taking this so-called global GP become a China LP approach. And the model D, I think just like all the other all players here on the stage, setting up a liaison office using the offshore available funds to do the investment into Chinese steel's offshore holding entity. And the model D, I think this still, there are quite a lot of companies taking a more wait and see, or even take more conservative, long-term, serious view to see how to enter China market. For this model, I would say that Dan Baker of Sutter here initiated, pioneer, and fine-tuned this approach in 1999. Then Sutter here invested $8 million into Chenwei. And then in 2004, another $8 million to the second fund of Chenwei. And last year, $5 million into TDA, the second fund. So here, I think the relationship between the China GP team and the foreign GP team is quite varied. Some are just passive limited partner, and some are involved more deeply in terms of the advisory committee, in terms of decision making, and some, I think some of them waive all the management fee, and some of them participate in the carried interest sharing. I think here the most impressive one should be Ignition teaming approach. Even without the Ignition brand, I would say that with the two long-term partners of Ignition relocated to China, work together with other people like Derek Bruchel, like Duan from Intel Capital, like Edward Zhou from Cisco. I think this kind of setup, not only headquarters and then China operation across the Pacific, but the people from the headquarters relocate to China, settle down there as part of the partners into the new China team. I think this is a very big commitment. And here are more people jumping on. I think even though that is just a short history, but still there are quite some VC-backed successful entrepreneurs. They're turning to serial entrepreneurs. They even jump over the table to become the venture capitalist. And some of them participate as a limited partner to some of the funds. And some turn into angel investors. We are very proud that two of the entrepreneurs supportive of our early fund vintage 2000 become the limited partner to our new fund, and we also continue to back up their second startup. And here, you will see some of the list of the people participate, become the venture capitalist. And the reshuffling of VC professionals, I think this is also a very important development in China. People tend to exchange name card nowadays. And here I put up some of the sample list. Of the Thomas Ng, maybe he's not like a professional jumping from one firm to another firm. He's the founder of PDF and also the co-founder of Granite. He's just focusing all his resources and attention into Granite now. And this TDF, it's interesting to see that when venture TDF restructuring into TDF partners, and this TDF, you know, there's a Tina, there's a David, and so the F. Paul is John, Paul is John Yim, so a good name is very important to participate in a good company. And much more funding, chasing quality deals. Yeah, I think last year, $4 billion, according to Gavin, another $900 million in the first quarter. And definitely, there are more money and there are less quality deal flow for the fund to invest. This is the last slide. If we can do it Chinese, Weiji means risk, the chaotic, the turmoil, and jihui is the opportunities. So it's always opportunity emerge out of a chaotic, risky environment. And the last point is very important. In a very underdeveloped Wild West, I think local partner is very important for any foreign players to do a good job in China. And anyone like to have a soft copy of this, you can download from this website, www.ittechventures.com.cn. And we have an invitation. Thank you.
Thanks so much for drawing the landscape on some of the partnership, and we're going to touch on that.